Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower. I am so not a rebel. I always like my bed to be neat and tidy. Thanks, Mom. Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life. Drink up. It's got electrolytes. No smiling. Take your power seriously. Warren is blowing up my inbox now. As long as he helps me figure this out. This is so insane, it sounds logical to me. This wormhole thing makes total sense, but doesn't explain how I can do what no scientist ever has. I would say this is some crazy shit, but now I'm not so certain. Should I sign? And I thought I was into Halloween. Dana is not messing around here. It would be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games. Okay, Max. Let's hit the showers now. Whoa! Hello, zombie face. This is what happens when you research quantum physics all night.
Not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry. Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I'm so consider it done.
Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
What's up, Kate?
School.
That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up, and you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
I better get dressed than go give back Kate's book. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Hello? Water?
Sorry. I forgot. Oops, I forgot about the water pressure. Otter power? I'm so not there. I'm good to flow, thanks. Thanks for the warning. I need to get dressed before I go there. Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time. No book here. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. I better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems. Be gone, foul soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine. Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if, good morning, Lisa. Your leaves are lovely today. I may not have a green thumb, but I have a green finger. Warren is blowing up my inbox now. As long as he helps me figure this out. Cartier-Bresson, Doisneau, Hamilton, the Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall. Now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive. Damn, it's the all-American zombie family. It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Almost forgot what Kate looks like when she smiles. Ouch. She left out damnation. That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes. Kate really has a doting father. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella.
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
That's awful. So, how did that happen?
It's a long story. I'm still trying to sort it all out.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Are you sure it was just one sip?
I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Did you go?
Definitely not. I'm not sure where I went.
What do you remember about that?
All I recall is driving for a long time. Then I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag. So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened. Jesus, this is intense. If Kate wasn't out of it and is actually telling the truth...
Fine, I won't disturb you.
No Brooke here.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
Why should I?
Because it's fucking hilarious. Church girl gone wild.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touché. Now I feel like an ass. Thanks for finding out the truth yesterday.
What did you do about Victoria pulling that crap?
Nothing yet. My mind works in devious ways, too.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit. Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
Who will survive and what will be left of them? Don't say that out loud, dork. That would be fun to put skulls and ghosts all over Blackwell. Like I could pull this look off. Hello, Victoria. What's happening, Dana? Everything cool between you and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again for releasing me from her captivity. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
No, sorry. It's just not my thing.
You came to Blackwell to discover yourself, not hide in your dorm.
I won't discover myself avoiding projectile vomit from bro dudes. Thanks anyway. Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
Did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual.
Go away! People sleeping!
Clearly not a morning person. The birds are flocking around Samuel. Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk, for once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy, too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
Never mind, Taylor.
That was a great talk, Max. Let's not do it again. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Max, check it out!
Warren, what are you doing here?
Well, nothing. Waiting. For a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
That was intense. Everything happened so fast. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero.
You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star.
Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
He's dangerous. I don't want you to get involved. You got me there, but lay low. Nathan Prescott is going to get his karma soon.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
Dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same. Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them.
Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
You did pretty good to have lasted this long.
Oh, the fish used to jump onto my boat until the Prescotts and their finance fiends snapped up harbor rights.
The Prescotts have a lot of power.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay. If that tells you much.
Do you know them?
Do good for my working kind. I know them through their bad deeds. Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there. Smell of breakfast and the sound. Now that brings back memories. Chloe and I. Good lord. Talk about apocalyptic. Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now, that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese.
How well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
Just curious. I'm surprised he's not a police officer in Arcadia Bay.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard she even just got busted with pot in her room.
That's not good. Anyway, that bacon sure smells good.
Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
No, I think she's just had some bad luck.
You have to create your own good luck. I think Chloe would rather destroy. But I'm just a cop, not a psychologist, so...
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
Our family never went whale watching. It looks fun.
And there she is, a lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But I wish you'd been here to help save Chloe. She got busted yesterday smoking out. Again.
I know. Chloe told me that her stepfather hit her.
I am sorry that was your introduction to David. I hope you get to know him on your terms, not Chloe's. He's a good man. He just...
Yeah, I'm sure he is since you married him, but don't be so harsh on Chloe.
It's good you're here. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did, after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, Amin.
Why? What did Chloe tell you?
Well, Chloe texted me that David slapped her yesterday.
He feels awful, and he will be punished. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
He cares about Kate Marsh?
David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
I saw him arguing with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
The last good Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
One Belgian waffle for the hungry.
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
Girl, pronto.
One Belgian nerd graffiti. Warren, I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner, not a bar.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty.
Stick. The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment.
No beer? What kind of dive is this?
This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
From here, you'll love this. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
No, you're not. This is my treat. To you, for coming back to rescue my daughter.
Nobody needs to rescue me.
Unless you set your room on fire smoking out.
Oh God, here it comes. Didn't you and Sergeant Pepper already read me the riot act last night?
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way. Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation. And I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
I don't know.
Do you have some kind of power or not? Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything. You got this, Max. Now rewind and blow Chloe's mind. Well, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
$0.86.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time. Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck. You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way!
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. And now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Now I should rewind and tell Chloe everything that just happened. I'm going to... The trucker drops his...
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves with that.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor fight, and Joyce doesn't give a shit.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
The jukebox goes crazy.
Pretty bizarro.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Oh, so cool.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
You are really whiffing this. Fucking A.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So what?
I'm going to predict. The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops.
Did you break another cup?
Oh, way
really?
To go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch.
Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened.
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, girl wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave. Chloe finally believes me. And I wonder what kind of crazy shit she has in mind now.
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and what to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with too. Later, Mom!
Bye, Joyce.
Freedom!
I feel bad about Kate.
She'll survive you not taking that one call.
Now follow me, young Squire Max, so we can seriously tap your power and rule the world.
I hope Kate doesn't get upset I didn't answer. But I could rewind and answer her. Present.
You can just back time up. We'll have to test you now to make sure. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
David might be a douche, but you did steal his gun. Is everybody armed in Arcadia Bay now?
Only the ones who shouldn't be, like Step Dildo. Until now.
I'm not in the revolution yet, Che.
You are the revolution, Max. So we should figure out how to best use and abuse your power with a test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
I bet I could get on the boat from a higher location. I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. Oh, gross. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground. All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth? I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. Every car has its own tale and history. This is the scariest thing here. Hello, bottle number 1. 4 more to go. This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about That kind of hurts. I can't see Chloe playing with makeup. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mistake. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel.
Boom, only 3 bottles left. I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote? So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared. Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel. I bet I could get on the boat from a higher location. Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Three down, 2 more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again. We're hiding out and plotting our future. Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. So happy. Like we've both gone back in time. Stupid bottle. Look what we have here. A cute little bottle for the taking. Hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students. One more bottle to go. Beyond repair. Rest in peace.
Wow, sir. That looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision. That dough is the perfect photo op. I know there's a bonfire spot where people party around here. I'm sure this is a popular party pit. Voila! Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road.
You're serious about this?
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim.
Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
That was so fucking cool! Now for the second bottle.
Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Now, Max, where do I
aim? Slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max.
I bet you want to blow apart those old computer monitors.
Let's reboot them with a bullet. Old school. Give me something to shoot, Max.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like, never. So I want one more uber-cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
Let's see what happens when you shoot the gas tank.
Step back. Gas tank go boom. Car definitely down, but no bottle casualties.
Feels good, but I didn't hit any of the bottles. Gas tank go boom. Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
Put a real dent in that front bumper.
Goodbye, cruel bumper. Jesus, I shot myself! Ugh, I shot myself! Back up, back
Stupid
up!
Stupid gun. Hold on, Chloe.
Dude,
how about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero! Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max! You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Okay, looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo, Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this, and I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now,
and I- That's Rachel's bracelet! Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, alright? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't! You stole that shit! Give it to me right now, asshole!
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please, step back.
You're kidding. Put that down. Come on, girlie. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead.
And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me. Chloe's waiting to go for a wowzer. Why did Frank have Rachel?
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
Seriously, Chloe, this is scary. What if Frank tries to track us down?
I'm sorry, but Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers. Obviously don't get my pot from you, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
Ah, no, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She had... has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect. Budget at all.
Come on, Max.
Damn, something is blocking the drum.
Please get me out of here.
Oh.
wedge locks the drum in place. Definitely use this bad boy.
Come on, Max! Hurry!
Now I can finally move the drum.
Get me out of here, Max!
I have to help lift Chloe up.
I got splinters in my ass and leg, so I wish there was a less violent way for you to save me. And now the trains can't get to the lumber mill. Oops. Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
It means shit happens, right?
No, crazy shit happens. Because it can. And will.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again. Little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that Vortex Club party?
Like I would miss it. I have the sweetest outfit.
Join us or die. Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care. I'm not anti-soiree. You seem anti-fashion, though. A Vortex Club party has a strict dress code. Do you even have a dress? Sorry, but nice try. If I was normal, I'd be super excited about going to a major shindig.
I should go and see what I can learn. These elite assholes throw a lot of big parties. Another chance for Nathan Prescott to Does anybody believe this shit? You can really learn a lot about a school by the weird shit posted on the boards. Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
Do you mind if we talk about what happened yesterday with Chloe?
I don't think so. And you hit Chloe.
I'm sure she told you why. Did she mention she probably stole one of my guns?
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
You stepped between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
If my tornado vision came true, it would be the end of the world. I still have time. I could go see Warren playing Mad Scientist in the lab.
That reminds me, I have to score some weed from Nathan.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Funny, I was just thinking about you, Max. It's too bad you didn't sign the petition. Every signature counts, and yours might be the one that decided.
I'm just thinking about all the autumn photos I want to take.
Oh, this is my favorite time of year. I do love the season change. This whole campus is a visual delight. I know Mr. Jefferson loves to shoot around here.
You must like photography.
I do, but I'm certainly no artist. I'm all about the science. You can't debate numbers. I have to say, it's not quite autumn enough yet.
What about that snow yesterday? What's your scientific explanation?
Our climate is moving beyond explanation. Of course, some of the tribes here might see it different.
How's your campaign going?
It's missing somebody who should care. But no finger pointing here, Max. More people would rather send a text than sign a petition. That's how they keep us all distracted. Nobody will notice cameras on every square foot.
Some of us want to use our cameras for good.
But people like David Madsen want to use them to spy.
Jeez, I'm not like him, Miss Grant.
I know, Max. But the trick is to make sure Blackwell Academy does not end up like him.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Bring me the brain, Igor. Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but go potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug. Weird science. Think, big brain, think.
Hey, Warren.
Maxwell's
asking me.
Have that.
I actually think you should use a lot of potassium. I mean, a shitload.
See? Look at that smile. You're going to become a scientist yet. Let's do this thing. She blinded me with science. Yes! That was a blast! But let's keep it a professional secret. Cool? This can't be that hard.
Howdy, Brooke.
Hi, Max. Making your daily rounds?
I'm helping Warren with his latest experiment.
Oh, I guess he needed a neophyte assistant so he wouldn't be threatened. But you came to his rescue anyway.
Apparently, it's my nature.
Yet Warren ignores the experts right in front of him. Not that he would ask me for help anyway.
I wish I could bring a mini Warren with me to my science exams.
Stop acting so.
So you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine.
Excuse me, Max. Can you come over here?
Sure.
You look worried. Is everything okay?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max? I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Everybody knows. That's why I wanted to see you. Kate is being humiliated daily.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
I will. She's mad I missed her call today. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
Rachel was nothing like Kate. And Principal Wells said you had something on your mind you wouldn't tell him. You care to share?
Not right now. I'll tell you everything as soon as I figure it out.
I'd like to believe that, Max. It just seems like there's a lot of drama around you this week.
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Make me beautiful, Hayden. Vogue. Vogue. Vogue.
I'm kind of- Dana, you are out of control. Turn left, then right. Show
What's up,
me
Daniel?
Love.
Waiting to draw Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on. I hope you liked the sketch I did of you yesterday.
love. And it's my new avatar.
Excellent. I got tons of likes on FB. Ah, made you blush.
Shut up.
Someday your portrait may hang in the Daniel de Costa wing of the Louvre. We'll talk about it later.
That's a great sketch of Dana. Daniel is the real deal.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal. Like I give a flying fuck.
Or she'll run to Mr. Jeff.
Here comes the mysterious Max, disguised as a pixie hipster.
Like all the other precious twee artists here.
You really nailed me.
Meow! Bring out the claws. I love seeing chicks fight.
Right. Can I sit at my table now?
Max thought we were going to be buds. Fucking ha ha.
Assholes. Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say, and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit
down.
We have a lot to cover today, and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
It's cool that Mr. Jefferson published his own little book of photo tips.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student? Or a
I guess
friend?
Kate will miss class now.
I wonder how it would feel.
I'm worried about her.
Herself shot out all over the world for people to judge. No smartphones in class, Max. Put that away. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example, who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in mind.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
See that? Is this for real? It slipped out!
I didn't think she was that messed up.
Kate! No! Oh
God. She can't die. She can't. Not again. Not now. I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again. Keep going, Max. You
do it!
Yes.
Oh. What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself?
Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
Don't worry, Kate. Things will get better. I promise.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours. And we can get through this together. Let me help.
You are such a liar. You wanted to help by ignoring my phone call?
My phone died and I didn't have my charger. I swear.
I swear too. Bullshit. Everybody says that to get out of talking.
Not me. In fact, I was going to get a brand new phone.
Don't say anything if you're going to use a dead phone excuse. Just tell me you didn't answer.
I fucked up and I'm sorry. Look, I'm here for you now. Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. You have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon, then straight to the police. Think of it like we're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So, I want you to come with me now. Please. You don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Forever. Can we hug on it?
No! Nobody cares about me! Nobody!
What about your mother, Kate? You'll destroy her. She doesn't care about a video. She loves you.
You don't know my mother at all. She already thinks Satan has me on the fast track to hell. Let's prove it.
No!
Thank you.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us, but we have to go over what happened before Miss Marsh, before she did what she did. Officer Barry will be taking notes for the official police inquiry. I'm sure you'll give him your full cooperation. Such a tragedy. But there must be a reason for everything. We need to find out why Kate Marsh would be driven to such desperate action. As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duty seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
I saw Mr. Jefferson talking to Kate right before our class. Then she ran off crying.
Mark, I do know that Miss Marsh has assisted you on class events.
Kate, Miss Marsh has been very withdrawn lately. I assume this awful video was the cause. I hated seeing the students laugh at her. She was upset Miss Caulfield didn't return her calls. She felt rejected by the school.
She shouldn't have asked to be on video, macking with some dudes.
You ass! She didn't ask for any of this.
No, on the contrary. Max was right to bring this up. Now, I wanted to help, but I guess I was too late.
Well, now this is problematic. The publicity is rising, and perhaps you shouldn't represent Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes contest in San Francisco.
Are you serious?
I am. We don't need any negative press about that event. And we need to involve the Academy in possible disciplinary measures for you.
I understand. There are bigger things at stake than me. The life of a young girl, for one. Maybe you should investigate other staff members. Max told me she knew things about Mr. Madsen.
Let Max speak for herself. Everything we talked about here will be looked into. All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
I just can't believe it. It's like it wasn't even real. Watching her drop like a weight, I really thought I could save her. Like a superhero.
Come on, Max. Do not for a second blame yourself. Kate was on that roof for her reasons, not yours.
My hand just reached out.
Stop it. You were the only one with balls enough to run to the roof. You were the only one who cared.
Yeah, I sure made a big fucking difference. Maybe if more people cared. Better people than me.
You're the best person around.
Warren, I screwed up today.
That makes no logical sense.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
I believe you, Warren. I believe anything this week.